Why is it so weird when we run Dolby Vision on a Samsung TV? It's all about how Dolby Vision works on the lower level. Samsung TVs does not support Dolby Vision, instead opting for their own brainchild in HDR-10 Plus. HDR-10 Plus is a decent child, but not as loved or as popular as Dolby Vision. If you want to play with Dolby, you have to pay them a bit of a license fee, and Samsung is more keen on an open system. Both of these solutions provide dynamic HDR, meaning that you can master different scenes with a different HDR property, such as making the best HDR possible from a very dark scene or a very bright scene. The regular HDR-10 only gives you the one global settings per movie. Apart from dynamic HDR, Dolby Vision offers a higher level of image quality. It blends with SDR content in a seamless way, and it's much more common than HDR-10 Plus. You miss out on that with a Samsung TV or any other TV that lacks Dolby Vision. Now, Dolby Vision and HDR-10 Plus, they're both based upon the regular HDR-10. Both are backwards compatible. That means that Dolby Vision, together with the Samsung TV, will just fall back on the plain old HDR-10. And not this. So okay, I tricked the system, but this can still happen to anyone. I used a device from HD Fury. It's an HDMI switcher and downscaler with an audio output. Now, this device has some serious abilities to manipulate the signal, including adding the metadata necessary for supporting Dolby Vision. Basically, I'm tricking my Panasonic Blu-ray player into believing that the Samsung TV does indeed support Dolby Vision. And that might be cheating or pushing it, maybe? However, this can happen as well when using a regular HDMI splitter, especially when you try to compare different TV models and different TV brands side by side using that splitter. And there are reasons for all this. Number one, Dolby Vision relies on the display telling the source what it is capable of, such as peak brightness and the native color gamut of the panel. This is one to one, one source and one display. Not several different displays at once, as they all have different traits on color and light output. Therefore, Dolby Vision will most likely not work properly through an HDMI splitter. Second, Dolby Vision uses up to 12-bit YCbCr with a color subsampling of 422. This is a higher level than normal and closer to the quality in the production stage. All other consumer and video sources are based on a 420 subsampling. That is Blu-ray, streaming, broadcast, and so on. Yes, you might tell your Blu-ray player or PC or whatever to output something else. This only changes the HDMI output signal, not the video source itself. The short story here is that Dolby Vision uses 8-bit RGB tunneling to send the 12-bit 422 signal. Why? Because virtually every device and chipset are capable of handling an 8-bit RGB signal. Support for 12-bit 422 is not that common at all. The colors are weird because Dolby Vision encodes the color information in a different way. This RGB tunneling means that the Samsung TV receives an RGB signal and it handles the image as if it were encoded in RGB. As a result, the colors are decoded in the wrong way. You might have seen this before. And yes, you can on some TVs manually change how they decode the image as either RGB or YCbCr. Well, you cannot do that with this Samsung. There is no such option in the menus. But if you could, it would still look weird. I used the Meridio 7 with Dolby Vision and it is capable of some odd combinations. I can send Dolby Vision with a signal flagged as YCbCr. This way, the Samsung no longer decodes the color as RGB. But the image and the colors are still way off. Dolby Vision requires the right programming in both ends for things to really work. And the only way to get that is to pay Dolby the license fee. This is why you cannot force your way into getting Dolby Vision on a Samsung. Why get this weird running Dolby Vision through an HDMI splitter or any other video device, especially older devices? This is from a Samsung Q95T. The same results are likely from any other Samsung TVs or any other brand that lacks Dolby Vision. Hopefully, you learned something new today. Thank you.